Now, dear students, this question has come from the chapter called as Organisms and Populations, which is actually part of the last unit of 12th standard NCERT biology, and the unit is ecology. So this is a very important question, as it was asked last year in the CBSE board examinations for 2 marks. So to understand the answer of this question, please watch the entire video. Hey students, this is Praful and I welcome you all to One Page Biology. So let us try to understand the concept of population density. So for that, I have to draw one particular graph. Let us see. Now, as you all know, dear students, this is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. On the y-axis, I am writing population density, which is indicated by the symbol n. Whereas on the x-axis, I am writing time, which is indicated by t. Now, dear students, what do we mean by the concept of population density? What exactly is population density? Population density simply means the total number of individuals in the population. Like, for example, you can say that suppose if the population of our country, that is our country India, is approximately 1.2 billion. So we can say that is the population density of our country, because 1.2 billion people are residing in our country. Likewise, every country has got a different population density. So population density can be measured in terms of the number of individuals. Now, as you can see the graph, dear students, here I'm drawing a particular graph like this. Now, dear students, as you can see, this is a sigmoid shaped graph, right? So what is this sigmoid shaped graph indicating? Let's try to understand. Now, for example, at this point, the population density, that is at this particular point, the population density is zero. But with respect to the time, the population is actually increasing and it is becoming stable at this point. As you can see, dear students, that here the population is growing little steadily. Then it grows very rapidly in this particular point, and it grows till this particular point. After this point, the population density becomes stable, or you can say the population density has now stopped growing. Now, dear students, such a graph is called as a sigmoid graph, or you can also call it as a sigmoid curve. And this is nothing but logistics growth. Now, dear students, what do we mean by logistics growth? Logistics growth means that the population is initially rising. After a certain point, it will keep on increasing, and beyond a certain point, the population is becoming stable. Now, you may wonder, why exactly happens like that? The reason is, this particular point is called as the limiting factor. Now, dear students, as we all know that in nature, there are limited resources. Now, suppose if the population keeps on increasing, it will increase till a certain point. But beyond a certain point, there will be scarcity of resources, and as a result of which, population will not be able to grow after that point. And that is applicable for every organism, be it a bacteria, be it plants, be it different types of animals. So ultimately, the growth of any kind of organism depends on the availability of resources. So this is the point, dear students, where the resources are available to its maximum, and beyond which there will be scarcity of the resources, and as a result of which the population is becoming stable. This point, after which the population stops growing, is called as the carrying capacity. It is called as the carrying capacity, and this is usually denoted by the alphabet K. So let me write down, this is carrying capacity. So in the question, majorly it was asked that what is this particular point indicating, right, my dear students? So this point, which in the question they had asked, you have to answer that this particular point is indicating nothing but the carrying capacity. So if you have to define what exactly is carrying capacity, the answer is, it is nothing but the nature's limited capacity to support the growth of population. So remember, dear students, such a graph is called as logistics graph, or it is sometimes also, it is called as logistics growth. Sometimes it is also referred as the realistic graph. Now this particular graph is also known as Wollhorst-Pearl logistics growth. Now dear students, we can also remember the equation of this graph, which is nothing but dr upon dt is equal to r into n upon into k minus n upon k. So the equation is dr upon dt is equal to r into n, inside the bracket is k minus n upon k. So let me tell you what exactly is dn upon dt. Dn upon dt means it is change in the population density with respect to time. What is r? R is basically intrinsic rate of growth. And how it is calculated? It is nothing but birth rate minus the death rate. What is n? N is population density. What is k? K is nothing but the carrying capacity. As we just said, carrying capacity is nature's limit to support the population growth. So this is how the equation of a realistic growth looks like. Second part of the question was, what are the different natural forces which can lead to such a growth, right? That means, as we can see, that the growth is increasing and then afterwards it is becoming stable. So what are the factors which can lead to such a kind of growth? Suppose the number of trees go on decreasing, and we all know that trees are very important because we are getting oxygen from them. If the trees get reduced, ultimately the human population cannot survive. So there are certain factors like the natural resources, if they get reduced, the population will go on decreasing. And that's why, dear students, it is very important to grow trees. Dear students, if you think there are any other possible reasons because of which the population can go down, you can please comment in the comment section and let me know. Okay, I will give you one more question to solve at home, and you can post the answer in the comment section. Try to find out, there is another graph which is also possible if there are unlimited natural resources. So just imagine, if there are unlimited natural resources, what kind of growth or what kind of graph will be shown by the population? If you find the answer, please write it in the comment section. So let's see who can answer this question. If you have understood the concept of population density, please like, share and subscribe to One Page Biology. I will be coming with more and more board related topics as well as the NEET related MCQs, explanation in my coming videos. So see you all in the next video, dear students. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.